Hey guys, my name is Divya. I am a doctor and I've held a management role with a healthcare company for a while. I am SHRM certified and PGMP certified from the Project Management Institute. I've been making a series of videos on my channel to help everybody in the community get certified both by SHRM and PMI. So if these videos are helping you, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel. It would really mean a lot to me because it would help me keep me motivated and make more videos. Okay guys, so today I just wanted to talk about one tip that has helped me over the years with various management exams that I've taken. What it is that keeps me going and helps me with retention and understanding in terms of studying and getting certified. So my good old tip, and it's an age old tip, is for everybody to use a notebook and pen or pencil. Use good old paper and pen, guys. Good old paper and pen while studying, and it would really help you out. So what I mean by that is while studying, while reading a topic, what I always do is read a topic, close the textbook, and then jot down the main gist, the important points from that particular topic or paragraph. So let me give you an example. If I were studying what is a management plan for the PMP, I would read the topic in Rita Malkahi's book, close the book, and then pick up my pen and paper and jot down a few things. What's the definition of a management plan? You know, it's a set of documents that has processes, standards, policies and procedures. What would I do while preparing a management plan? What would I do while executing it? All these things would be summarized in basic points, not flowery long sentences, but just basic points to see that I can actually recollect it from my memory. So similarly, if I were studying for the SHRM exam and I were doing a topic called job descriptions, I would always think back, I would close the book, then I would pick up my pen and paper and think of what other synonyms do job descriptions go by. So position descriptions would be one of them. You know, what does a basic job description contain? I would jot down all those points in terms of what it contains or what it doesn't, and how it is different from one place to another. Do geographical differences affect what a JD looks like? So these are things that you one must keep in mind while you're studying for an exam. And the reason I wanted to bring it up is something that I've mentioned in a previous video. So these days, screen time is really a lot. We're attending meetings via the phone or a company chat app. We're studying and taking mock exams on our laptops, and we sometimes end up making notes on our laptop itself. Like when we're studying, we open up any text editor and then we start jotting down something or recollecting something while we're studying. I think it's way more productive if you make all those studying notes on pen and paper. So I'm not someone who made copious notes in my life. I'm not someone who went and rewrote the PMP standard or, you know, the learning management system offered by the SHRM. I really don't do that because my fear is that I would miss something. And if I miss something while making notes, and those are the notes that I use for reviewing or revising the material, then I would miss the same points over and over again. And the whole point of rereading something is to recollect better and is to connect better with the material. So that means you would read more and you would remember more. So here is my sincere tip to you. Use pen and paper while studying, not just to make notes, but to be able to recollect things topic by topic while you're studying. So people often think that studying is like reading, and while you're reading a novel or a chapter and paragraph, you're actually transferring things from the book to your brain. But I really think it's the opposite. So when you're doing effective studying, you're not putting something by reading into your brain, you're actively recollecting it from your brain and putting it down on a piece of paper. So it's like output versus input. You're not inputting or entering information while studying. You really have to be able to retrieve it. And I think that's the true test of effective studying. So for effective studying, I do recommend good old pen and paper. Use it to jot down notes. One last thing I want to say in this video before I sign off. I keep getting comments asking me what kind of gadgets and tools that I are some you know are tools that I've used while studying. And honestly, guys, it's minimal. I do have a laptop, but that's about it. And I don't really use it for active studying, meaning most of my books are paper books. And I only use the laptop to take mock exams or time myself while taking a practice exam because that's just where the exam is. But I really prefer good old pen and paper. The other question I've been asked is whether I own an iPad Pro or another fancy tablet, and I don't. I really don't because, as I said, pen and paper, good old, write things down while you study because that will really improve the effectiveness of how you're studying and how much you're able to recollect for the exam. Once again, I do hope the videos are helping you. Thank you so much for watching.